Welcome to Classic Test Finishes. Over the last decade, we've witnessed some exciting and thrilling moments in Australian Test history. For the first time on video, we've selected six such matches. Not necessarily for the result, but rather for the key aspects of the game, like the closest win in the history of Test cricket, or the last Test by two great Australians. So sit back for 2 hours of non-stop Test cricket action, commencing with the 1982 Test at the MCG.
The first day of the fourth Test match at the Melbourne Cricket Ground, a day where the game is to be played on a newly laid surface, which might pose problems for the players. A quick look at the two teams nominated for this match. The Australian fast bowler, Carl Rackerman, failed a fitness test and he is out. And Graham Wood is 12th man for Australia. For England, Eddie Hemmings is 12th man. And Fowler and Cook are the opening batsmen. They've gone in with four quick bowlers, Willis and Cowans, and Pringle and Botham. So it's a good, strong bowling lineup, but they haven't the opportunity of bowling first on this pitch. So that might fall away a little in importance, particularly with Hemmings, the off-spinner, being left out. The Australians, well, Graham Wood, 12th man. The pace bowlers, Geoff Lawson, Rodney Hogg, and Geoff Thompson, who did so wonderfully well in Adelaide in the extreme heat. And the same batting lineup. Rackerman, as I say, having failed the fitness test, is out. This pitch, newly laid, and Geoff Lawson about to bowl the first ball. Everyone's eyes will be on this strip in the first session. The ball should bounce around a bit. And above all, for the pace bowlers, it should move off the seam. The man taking strike is Geoff Cook, the non-striker Graham Fowler. And here's Geoff Lawson for the first ball with Ian Chappell and Keith Stackpole in the commentary box.
Thanks very much, Richie. And a fine sight it is, a nice brown wicket. Perfect cricketing day here at the MCG. A magnificent catch as Rodney Marsh was heading down the leg side.
Thompson to Geoff Cook.
And he's out. Greg Chappell's got him. Two out of two has Greg Chappell taken. Cook going for the drive there. Thick outside edge and he's out, caught by Greg Chappell, which makes Greg Chappell now the most prolific taker of catches in the history of Australian Test cricket.
Shot, glorious shot off the back foot. And the crowd comes alive as Gower takes the attack to the Australians. Beautifully timed shot, through point.
Hogg to Gower.
And there's Nick Nadine. He's out. Marsh has done it again. Rodney Hogg finds the outside edge of Gower's bat, and that was magnificent bowling and a huge victory for Australia.
Here's Rodney Hogg now to Taveray.
There's the 54, Chris Taveray. Straight driving Rodney Hogg down the ground, a shot that he doesn't play very often.
Oh, and he caught him. He's gone. Out caught in the gully. That was a magnificent catch there by Yardley. He hit that ball like a tracer bullet, and Yardley has gone straight up off the ground and snaffled it out of the air.
Cullen Lamb faces Yardley. Dyson. A safe pair of hands. Botham now faces Bruce Yardley.
And that's gone. A sharp catch there to a couple of vessels. And a little bit of extra turn there for Bruce Yardley. England 6 for 259.
Yardley to Miller.
There's an appeal, a very strong appeal. And Geoff Miller has been adjudged caught at bat pad by Alan Border.
Yardley to Taylor.
Big shout, he's out, yes, bat on the pad, straight up in the air, and a big shout from Rodney Marsh, and Yardley strikes again, four wickets for Bruce Yardley. And what a catch, what a ripper! Vessels of short legs taken, one of the best catches you will ever see. It's in the air, Walsh is coming around for mid-off, he's getting under it, and what a beauty! Superb outfield catch. The bowl was Rodney Hogg, and what a great finish for the Australian team.
What a marvellous way to end the day. What a great catch that was. Geoff Lawson didn't get a wicket, but that catch made up for it all, and a fitting way to end it for the 64,000 people who were here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. The England batting card makes quite startling reading. 284 all out, At one stage, it looked to me as though they could go on easily and make 400. Lawson, no wicket for 48. Hogg, 4 for 69, and Yardley, 4 for 89, showed the virtues of courage and determination. Thompson, 2 for 49, only bowled 13 overs today, and Chopper bowled the one over for 5 runs.
And he's off the mark. Bowled nice and straight, and this big crowd cheers the start to the Australian innings.
Now, Bob Willis, will that inspire the England captain? Pepper Vessels with a glorious stroke down the ground. Well, that's close. Yes, John Dyson is LBW, and Cowans deserves that wicket.
He starts with a bouncer to Greg Chappell, and Alan Lamb has picked him up that deep backward square leg, so he's got Greg Chappell with another bouncer.
So the trap was set, the second wicket is down, 2 for 55.
Cowans comes in now, Hughes is taking strike.
A short one there to Hughes, and it just goes wide of Bob Willis. Only to pick him up 4 runs.
The Vessel is taking strike, Bob Willis is the bowler.
It's got him over! A good delivery bowling wide and length, and it's not easy to bowl a couple of Vessels. He's out bowled for 47.
Both them to border.
It's bowled in! That's it! An absolute there, straight through to the gate. I think he might have got a tiny little inside edge, but he was done by the swing. It was great bowling by Ian Botham, pitching that one up, and a big blow for Australia. Alan Border, out-bowled by Ian Botham.
Hammering away there.
Well played. It's in the air, and it's going down towards deep square leg, but it's going to be 4. The man has been placed on the boundary down there, very square, hoping that Hughes will hook it square in the air. He didn't that time. He played it a bit finer, and it's 4.
Pringle comes in to David Hooks.
Well bowled, he's gone. Yes, he's got him. What a breakthrough for England. It's well deserved by Derek Pringle. That was a fine spell of bowling. He never gave Hooks any width at all. And full credit to the young medium pacer.
And now Australia, after having been 5 for 180, are going on with the job.
Once again, Rodney Marsh lofting away to the outfield, but very sensibly on that occasion.
Bob Willis to Hughes.
And that's got him an inside edge from a ball that kept a little low. The inside edge coming back onto the stumps.
Miller to Bruce Yardley.
Bowl him, spun and got through his defence, so it worked. And Jeff Miller breaks through for England. Yardley a clean bowl.
Willis to Marsh.
Bowling round his legs as Jeff. Dennis Willey pointed out earlier that Rodney Marsh has been bowled quite often round his legs, and Willis probed and probed and finally beat the pad and struck the stumps, and England right back in this test match.
Jeff Miller bowls to Lawson.
Sweeps in the air, he's out, he's gone, caught backward a square by Fowler. Attempting a sweep just short of a length, and Fowler backward square leg took a straightforward catch.
Jeff Miller to Geoff Thompson.
Tomo's had a swing and a miss, and he's bowled. So, Australia all out for 287. Thompson bowled by Miller.
What a great day's cricket that was. A lead of just 3 runs for the Australians after they were bowled out for 287. 284 to England yesterday, and both sets of bowlers can be proud of the way they've reacted to the tension and atmosphere down here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. And the scorecard at the end of the day's play, 287 Australia with a top score, Kim Hughes. 66, 253s, one each to Hooks and one to Marsh, and Kepler-Vessels 47, he played very well in that partnership of 55 with John Dyson. And the England bowling figures, Bob Willis 3 for 38, I thought he was under bowled today, but he can only blame himself for that. Ian Botham 1 for 69, then Cowans 2 for 69, Pringle 1 for 40, and some very heady bowling by Jeff Miller.
And so Lawson now on his way in to bowl to the right-handed Jeff Cook. And England away almost immediately. Down to mid-off. And, oh, there's a mix-up.
Oh, what a marvellous piece of cricket that was. Bruce Yardley again. That was great anticipation.
Oh, a great delivery there from Rodney Hogg. Cutting back and going right through the gate.
Jeff Lawson to Gower.
And there's an appeal there, and Gower is on his way. Caught down the leg side once again. Caught by Rodney Marsh from the bowling of Jeff Lawson. And I don't think it's a very happy David Gower.
And cuts, and what a glorious shot. What a great way to get off the mark. And this player's having a fine tour. Not to be intimidated under the back foot.
Getting rough behind one of Australia's great fast bowlers. Outside off stump, smashed away on the offside. Beautiful shot by Alan Lamb. That's racing away down to the extra cover boundary.
Well, that was a beautiful shot.
Rodney Hogg to Graham Fowler. And he's bowling. And he's gone. Brilliant piece of work by Rodney Hogg. Lawson to Miller.
And there's a very strong appeal, and that has to be out. Tony Crafter not in much doubt about that one.
Oh, it's in the air, and Chappell's got him. Both of them's out. That's a big breakthrough for Australia. It's out, yes, he's gone, drawing away. Did it strike him on the thigh pad or did it strike him on the glove? Taylor looks back.
Beats him. He's gone. Is he gone? He's gone. And Marsh has broken the record. And what a catch. 27 dismissals in a series.
Lawson to Cowans.
He's got him again. It's high and wide down backward square leg. The short delivery bounces over the fence for four. He's got him. And he's out. Had to happen. England bowled out four. 294. And Jeff Lyson's Lawson strikes again.
Well, what a day that was, and what a match it's been. And the Australians now need 292 to win this match tomorrow and the next day. Magnificent performance by England today. They turned on a real effort of guts and determination out there to make 294 after they'd lost their first three wickets very cheaply. Three heroes for Australia in the bowling. Jeff Lawson, 4 for 66. Rodney Hogg, 3 for 64. And Geoff Thompson fought back well after he was expensive early on to finish up with 3 for 74. The disappointment, Bruce Yardley, who again in the second innings of a match failed to extract much life from the pitch. 15 overs, two maidens, none for 67.
Waiting for the inside edge, and there was one, and there's a mix-up. Willis, no, it's not, it's Pringle, and he's up. That one going way down towards deep extra cover, Gould's off with, and it will go into the fence. So four overthrows there, resulting from shy by Pringle, who's fielding at a wide mid-on position. It's the sort of catch that has to be taken if they're to win this match. They're 2-0 down. And he's done him again in the same spot. That was well planned. It's that little shuffle round about leg stump. And he's gone. Brilliantly caught. Ian Gould, the 12th man. Ian Botham, and he's bowling to John Dyson.
He's gone. Just as he gave him a bit of a wrap, Pringle takes a fine catch at second slip. And Botham strikes again for England. That's the answer from David Hooks. That's well played. Runs is so valuable today that that gamble didn't pay off. Hooks picked it up. Crunched it forward a point for four runs.
Here's Geoff Miller, and he's bowling to David Hooks.
Hooks again giving himself room, and marvellous placement there. And once again, his timing coming into play. This is a dangerous time for England. David Hooks is starting to look good as he brings up his 50.
There's a chance. They're going for the catch off the back of the bat. He's out. Yes, what a great piece of work by Bobby Taylor. It's in the air. Bob Willis is going for it. He's caught it. What a super catch by Bob Willis. 33 years of age. The captain of the England side. And did they need Bob Willis? And he didn't let Norman Cowans down. That was a beautifully judged catch. Under tremendous pressure. His face says it all.
Oh, it's a big appeal, and this must be close. He's out. LBW to Bob Cowans. That's a big breakthrough. And have a look at the English players. They know exactly how important that wicket was. That one looked to me to have kept a little bit low. Rod Marsh out to LBW.
Oh, he's bowled it.
That one didn't bounce either. Well, well, well.
The friendly to move in. And that's up in the air. And it's Cowan underneath it. And it's out. He's gone for the hook shot again as Lawson, and Cowan has taken the catch. And that's Australia's eighth wicket gone down.
And very straight bowling there. And Rodney Hogg is on his way. LBW. And that is really good bowling from Norman Cowan.
He smashes that back with a point. It could be four. He missed that, and it's four more. 42 runs for victory. Gordon drives, he looks for two, it's wide. Lamb coming across. Going for the second. Got him! No, he's home! Oh, photo finish.
Let's have a look at the scorecards now. At the close of play, Australia, with that partnership between Border and Thompson, took the final score along to 9 for 255. The bowling figures for England: Norman Cowans, 20 overs, 3 maidens, 6 for 69. Those of us who've been saying he's been badly done by, I think, have underlined the point there. Willis, no wickets. Botham, 1 for 72. Pringle, 1 for 26. And Geoff Miller, 1 for 30. I thought bowled extremely well today.
Thompson, the batsman. Well, this is England's chance. Well, Thompson's new at the crease. Doesn't get used to the pace of the wicket. The crowd cheering every ball. Big shout. Rex White in under pressure, going down the leg side. Won't the umpires be tested this morning? Anything that's anywhere near close, they'll be up.
He's got that one away for a single.
Bob Willis to Thompson.
Once again, Thompson giving himself room. And there's a chance for three here, I would say. Alan Border will probably take it. Yes, coming back with the third. So 23 is now the target. And Border's gone. And oh, and in their rush to get it at Geoff Thompson, who was not backing up.
Owen is bowling to Alan Border.
Alan Border is 50, and they'll be looking for two here. And very well run, Geoff Thompson. Alan Border moves along to 51, and he won't make many more valuable 50s than that.
Might have to go down as a chance. He's got it through. Speeding across the outfield, but it won't quite go. They're going to be happy enough with three. And Gower's not game this time to let it go for four. So Hall is going to look for two here and should get it satisfactorily. And there, Mr. Fielder. And now it's a quarter win for Australia. Ian Botham bowls now to Geoff Thompson.
Three runs.
Well, what about that then? What a marvellous game of cricket this has been here at the MCG. Three runs, the lowest winning margin ever, equaling the one in 1902 at Old Trafford. A fantastic performance by both teams to provide such entertainment. And I'm certain England were getting very, very nervy out there. Even the touch of panic buttons at one stage seemed to be hit by the fielders running into one another and one or two other little disasters. Just a reminder of the scorecards. The Australian second innings, 288, just four runs short of victory, with Border 62 not out, Thompson 21, caught by Miller off Botham, and the partnership was worth 70. Welcome to the highlights of the first day's play of this final test match at the SCG. They're shortened a little bit because the play was shortened. The umpires couldn't start until 4:30 p.m. And the reason for that was that there was a lot of heavy rain here at the SCG yesterday. It rained again last night and it fairly threw it down this morning between about 7 o'clock and 10 o'clock. At one stage there was a miniature lake out in the centre there and the umpires couldn't even get a look under the covers. The teams, well, Pakistan have gone in with the same side, but Australia have made two changes. Maguire has been made 12th man and Bennett has gone out of the squad.
That's
in the air, but picking the gap between Kim Hughes and Graham Yallop. That's in the air to Alan Border, and a good catch by the man at second slip, and a very good outswinger from Dennis Lilly.
Dasser on strike. Edge and down through that area again. There's a gap between fourth slip and gully, the ball racing away down towards the third man boundary, another four to Pakistan. Slower ball and nicely placed. Matthews, the fielder. Oh, what a good catch. Border again, two to him. Both times, Lilly the bowler, and a breakthrough for Australia.
The leg cutter again, hitting the shoulder of the bat and travelling very quickly to Border, who seemed to come across in front of first slip. I wonder if Border had not taken this, would it have gone to first slip and to Greg Chappell, who now is just one catch short of that elusive 120 record of Colin Cowdrey. So Kazim Omar is out, 2 for 57.
Abdulkadir is off the mark, he's going to come back, and the throw is in no man's land there. Actually, that's good cricket by Abdulkadir, trying to make sure that Madassar Nazar has to face as little as possible. That's well played by Abdulkadir and beautifully bowled by Dennis Lilly. Well, honours just about even there, but great performance from Dennis Lilly to pick up those two wickets. 2 for 20 he had. The batsman out, Mohsin Khan for 14 and Kazim Omar for 15. Pakistan fought very hard there, but in the end they had to send in night watchman Abdulkadir to see it out through the full 22 overs and 92 minutes. 2 for 61 with Madassar on 26 and Abdulkadir 2. Lilly, 9 overs, 3 maidens. 2 for 20 has gone on to 349 victims.
On the edge there, and Alan Border not quite able to grab that one. There's a chance, and Cardia has been taken this time. It's Kim Hughes at fourth slip.
Lilly to Madassar.
It's a good shot from Madassar. Outfield a little quicker today. And that's the first boundary of this morning for Madassar.
That's going down the hill. No chance of Matthews cutting that off.
And that's in the air and straight to Dennis Lilly at mid-wicket. And Jarvid very annoyed with himself for that lapse in concentration. There's the bouncer, and that's hit on the back of the bat. That's Dougie Walters at his best, leaving the periscope up as he goes down. And that's an edge, and Greg Chappell has got it, number 120. So the move to second slip has paid off.
In the air. Safely caught by Yallop. Imran Khan has gone, and that's trouble. Lawson has struck again. He's bowled well in this spell.
The short delivery from Greg Chappell dispatched quite comfortably away to backward square leg. Salim goes over mid-wicket. So there really is a sense of urgency now about this Pakistan innings. Plenty of swing there for Geoffrey Lawson, but just what Zahir wanted. New ball goes quicker off the bat. Short one in reply, down to mid-on. And Dennis Lilly getting another catch, his second one, both off Geoff Lawson deliveries.
Worth a shot, yes. I don't think he was forward at all there. Looked to me as though he just put his front foot a matter of an inch or two outside the crease.
And Safraz has the distinction of becoming Dennis Lilly's 350th test victim.
And that has got to be out. Graham Yallop, safe catch. Zahir, none too happy at that. And he's gone this time. Courtmarsh, Bowl Lily, 350 victims for Marsh. What a nice way to do it.
Big effort all round by the Australians as Dennis Lilly and Jeff Lawson lead the side off the ground.
Well, that was a tremendous effort from the Australian side there in that second session of play and the one that followed. They kept Pakistan tied down. The bowlers worked very, very hard in what was a very, very sticky day, high temperature around about 30 degrees all day, and Kim Hughes kept them up to the mark all the time. I was very, very impressed with their effort. The scorecard for Pakistan, 84 to Mudassir Nazir, top score. That was Greg Chappell's 120th test match catch to equal the world record previously held on his own by Colin Cowdery. 61 to Zahir Abbas, who played very well today. It took him 212 minutes and he hit six fours, but he was in good touch. And Salim Malik, well, how fortunate was it for Pakistan that, in fact, he was retained in the side. 54 in 99 minutes, a very good innings from him. But the bowling figures make marvellous reading for Australia. Lilly, 31.2, 10, 4 for 65. And Lawson, 25, 5, 5 for 59. And young Matthews bowled very well too, although he had only the one wicket, 1 for 59 in 18 overs, 4 maidens. A fine performance from him, one of the younger stars coming up in the Australian lineup.
Oh, that's got to be out. Yes, he's given him. Vessels out, caught behind. That must have been an inside edge because the ball came back a long way and Borey, who was moving to his left, had to go to his right.
Porter Phillips. That's the first one in South Francis over the pitch. Actually, it wasn't bad bowling. Mudassir Nazir to Yallop. Shot. Beautifully played by Yallop. Still slow in the outfield on that side of the ground, but quick enough. That's a good shot and it deserved four runs.
Be that as it may, when he picked the ball up, his foot was outside the ground, and that's a big appeal. He's given out. Yes, he's gone.
And that's off the edge and well taken. He's a good slip fielder, Salim, and that was a brilliant catch. And that's Hughes' method of getting back at Kadir.
Shot. Beautiful shot.
Kadir. And a misfield there by Salim at backward point gives Greg Chappell his half century. That's a fine shot from Hughes. Picked the gap beautifully.
Safe. Not his best shot of the day, but four runs nonetheless. 50 for Kim Hughes. They're really going after them now.
Sofres to Chappell again. Quick single. In comes Mosen. He'll shy the stumps. Chappell's home. And they're overthrows. This could be it. Chappell turning for the second. He'll be back for the third. Hughes is flying. He'll come back for the fourth. And this run makes Greg Chappell the most prolific scorer of runs in the history of cricket in Australia. 18,000 people rise to their feet and cheer one of the greatest batsmen of all time.
And Chappell smiles, but listen to the crowd. Works Mudassar, there's the jump for the side.
And there the two. Kasim picks up. Chappell comes back for the second. And he has now scored 7,000 runs in Test cricket. He's the first Australian batsman to reach that target and becomes the sixth batsman in the history of the game to have scored 7,000 runs. A
passport of the day. And Kim Hughes and Greg Chappell will walk out in the knowledge that they've done a great job.
Yeah, it's a fine partnership by two great batsmen. They saved Australia for some embarrassment today when they were 3 for 83. A tremendous ovation for Greg Chappell, and what a great day for him and his family.
And that was a marvellous ovation for Greg Chappell and Kim Hughes when they came off the field. Chappell, because he broke the record, and because he became the first man to reach 7,000 runs in Test match cricket for Australia. Kim Hughes, because he led from the front once again and played a superb little innings, and their century partnership has put Australia right back on top. The scorecard at the end of the day, 3 for 242. Greg Chappell on 79, Kim Hughes 76, 371 minutes from 94 overs, and the men out, Vessels 3, Phillips 37, and Yallop for 30. That catch, it was in Bowie's, incidentally, to dismiss Yallop was his 200th in Test match cricket. My word, the records are going thick and fast out here at the SCG in this game.
Greg Chappell, in fact, looking for just one run to be the highest scorer for Australia against Pakistan at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Amazingly, no Australian has made a century against Pakistan here, although this is only the third test between the two countries on this ground. And that boundary will take him to 83 and that score, beating your old mate Redder, Staffy.
Hughes facing Safraz.
Oh, and that's got to be close. Yes, Kim Hughes on his way. A very good delivery there from Safraz. Cutting back quite sharply and also staying down just a fraction.
Shot. Beautiful stroke. What a marvellous way to bring up 100 with the classic cover drive we've seen so often over the years from this great player. His wife, Judy, is so pleased. She knows this is his last international game of cricket for Australia. A century to Greg Chappell.
And what a magic moment for us all.
Here's Alan Border now facing Safraz.
Oh, lovely shot. Beautifully played by Alan Border. That's the first one he's really hit in the meat of the bat.
That's in the air and down. Javed is the man at cover.
Abdul Qadir to Border.
But no, he's going to get stuck into the batsman.
And the batsman might get stuck into him as well. Alan Border relishes a challenge and has played extremely well so far this summer. Now goes on to a half century. Been consistent all the way along the line.
He certainly has. He's had a marvellous summer in the Test matches.
Got that through. The outfield is quicker over there. It's going downhill. Four more to Chappell. 150 up for Greg Chappell. Beautiful. Beautiful stroke.
And that is a grand shot. Two good boundaries to finish off the over with for Border. And the 400 comes up for Australia. An edge and a very good catch there from Wasim Bari as Madassa moved the attack across outside the off stump. Very good effort there from Wasim Bari.
Madassa Nazar to Greg Chappell. That's close. Yes, indeed. Kept a bit low, played across it, and I think it would have hit about middle and leg. And the whole crowd rises now to Greg Chappell. 182 in his last Test match innings. He made 108 in his first Test match innings in Perth. 182 in his last Test match innings at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Just a single again. This time Madassa is the man. And Kim Hughes has declared. A declaration comes from the Australian dressing room. Well, that was a good declaration from Kim Hughes. It gave him 45 minutes to have a go at the Pakistan openers. always the chance of picking up a wicket or two there, because their history of getting through a little period like that against Australia's fast bowlers under pressure has not been good so far in this series. A fine performance from the Australian batsmen, because at one stage they were 3 for 83 in that innings. They finished with 6 for 454. When they were 3 for 83, there was a real chance of a collapse. And the two partnerships that mattered were between Chappell and Hughes, 171, Chappell and Border, 153. And today, Greg Chappell became the first man in the history of the game to score a century in his Test match debut and in his last innings in Test cricket. When the Australians came out to field for that 45 minutes, there was a very nice and very memorable moment. The rest of their players standing back and allowing these two great cricketers to walk down the steps of the old members' pavilion, steps down which great players have passed since the time Test match cricket began.
Well, I think what he's actually done is inside those boots, he obviously got some heel pads in the air. What a catch! What a catch taken by Chappell. That gives him the record number of catches all on his own. 121 catches, and that was a good one.
Greg Matthews to Kazim Omar.
Full pitch, gets the works, rightly so. Doesn't matter if it's the first over or the last.
Always nice to dispatch one of those way to the boundary in the last over of the day. Well, that was well fought by Kazim Omar and Madhusudan Nazir there at the end. 47 for the loss of the one wicket, that of Mohsin Khan. And that wicket, well, once again, it was a record in this Test match that's brought so many, many memorable things. Greg Chappell's 121st Test match catch.
Madhusudan with a big job to do for Pakistan on this wicket, which was very good, as Tony Gregg pointed out, just the odd crack. And Lawson coming in from the members' end. And he's got him. He's out. He's bowled him. First delivery off an inside edge.
Lawson again. Bowling to Kasim. He's nicked it. And Rodney Marsh, has he got it? Yes, it's a fumble. He's got it, though.
So Rodney Marsh has taken the catch.
His run nowadays is not as long as it was when he first started in international cricket, but smooth.
Well, that again is safely away, but it wasn't all that well played. It was beautifully bowled.
Hog to Zahir.
And that's out. That is out. Rodney Hogg worked hard for that one.
Oh, and that's a good bowl ball, and he's given him out. Rodney Hogg has found the outside edge of Imran's bat, and Imran is very upset.
That's a good shot. And 50 to Shavid Mehrdad. Good knock, this. And there it is. No sooner called by Frank Tyson than it happens. And what a good delivery that was. Oh, that's a good one. That's a splendid catch. It was going very fast indeed. Lilly's got a wicket. And thank you very much indeed, he says.
A fine performance by the Australian fast bowlers.
Well, that's gone straight up in the air. Rodney Marsh is underneath it. This will be out. Yes, he's gone. Dennis Lilly is struck.
It's gone. Yes, Phillips at first. He took a smart touch. And once again, Dennis Lilly strikes again. It's out. Yes, that's it. Phillips at second slip takes the catch, and the great Dennis Lilly departs with four wickets. Australia need 35 runs to win this Test match, but what a Test match it's been already.
And what a nice way for Dennis Lilly to leave the field in his last international match. A boxing kangaroo flag draped over his shoulder and possibly a tear in his eye. There even be one in Greg Chappell's eye as he follows him up the stairs there. There are no more occasions where they'll be walking up those steps at the Sydney Cricket Ground. The card of the Pakistan second innings, they made 210.
That's a good shot from Kepler-Vessels. Sarfraz has given him a bit of room a couple of times. He's got away with it, but not on that occasion. That's a fine shot from Wayne Phillips. Crashing it away through the covers. And Australia 35. They've wrapped up this series.
Australia coasting in there
by 10 wickets. And a very, very fine victory it was, too, for Kim Hughes. Welcome to highlights of the first day's play of the final test between Australia and the West Indies. The test match which will be the last for Clive Lloyd, one of the greatest cricketers and men ever to grace the cricket field. The weather wasn't too good in Sydney for the start of play. 23 minutes were lost, in fact, with light drizzle before the umpires were able to go out in the centre. Alan Border won the toss, and the teams were very interesting indeed, showed quite a divergence of opinion on the part of the selectors of either side. The Australians, for example, went in with two spinners, Bennett and Holland, whereas the West Indians dropped Roger Harper and they've played all four fast bowlers, so they're certainly not thinking alike in that regard. We pick up play now in the third over. Three runs are on the board. Holding is the bowler. Graham Wood is taking strike, and your commentators are Bill Laurie and Keith Stackpole.
Hook shot. Safe. Bounces 20 metres to the right of Courtney Walsh. Gone! What a catch! Good delivery and a super catch by Dujon.
And Wood in the air, but wide of Courtney Walsh and into the square leg boundary.
It's in the air. Appeal all around. Not out, says umpire Mel Johnson.
There's no one out in that area. It's gone for four. 50 up for Kepler-Vessels.
Thank you, Tony. Out! What a catch! That is a classic catch at Coca-Cola Bottle of Beauty. Desmond Haynes at mid-wicket breaks the vital partnership.
Vessels on 98. Well played. This will be it. He's flying down the wicket. Back for the second. A huge cheer from this crowd. Kepler-Vessels has made 100 against the West Indies.
Walsh to Richie.
Oh, that's a terrible delivery, and he's hit him right in the face. That really did rear up for length. And straight away, Vessels calling to the dressing room. It looks like a nasty blow just below the eye there. That really was a nasty delivery.
That reared from Moyle was only just short of a good length.
But he's decided that he's had enough. He's gone right down the ground and hit it into the fence for four.
It was a very fine performance from the Australian batsman. Two for 235. Kepler-Vessels 120 not out, and Alan Border 19. The men out, Hilditch 2, Wood 45, and Richie retired hurt for 30. 77 overs bowled in the day, shortened by 23 minutes. So that's the equivalent of 81 overs in the day. Now, bear in mind that there were 18 of those bowled by Gomes and Richards, the spinners. I think that's a disgraceful over rate.
And immediately, Border produces a crashing square cut.
It's a 50 for Border, and a good one too. Steadily improved this series to match the performances he put up in the Caribbean, where he was the outstanding batsman. Not sure he timed that perfectly, but it's still racing away over the outfield. It's very slow down there, and Greenidge is going to go after it. They're going to look for four, but can't get it.
Slow ball and he goes for it. It's in the air. Gordon Greenidge is under it. He's gone. Slow delivery. Border trying to hit down the ground.
And it's going to be Michael Holding now. Been brought back now at the Randwick end, and he's off his short run initially. He's bowled him. He's dragged that one back onto the stumps. Kepler-Vessels off the back foot, trying to smash that through extra cover. Big inside edge, and then dragged it back onto his wickets. Richards picks up, shies the stumps, he'll be out of here. He's gone, he's run out by a mile.
Well, David Boone has been threatening to run every time he hits the ball. On that occasion, Richie decided to go with him.
It's in the air, he's under it, and there's the wicket. Rixon falls to Joel Garner, and the third wicket for Michael Holding. Slashes, top edge, races away, four runs to Murray Bennett. The crowd roars, there hasn't been much to cheer about in this final session. Bennett, fine shot. Breath of fresh air brings up the 400 for Australia. Good shot. Boone breaks the shackles with the boundary, square of the wicket on the offside.
That's the sixth one from the bat today.
Today Australia made 179 runs, and they took a long time in doing it. 75 minutes lost due to the rain, but the West Indies had them by the throat tactically towards the end. Clive Lloyd called the tune right from the moment Alan Border was dismissed. His bowlers bowled precisely as Lloyd wanted, and it finished up with a scorecard looking like this. Australia, 6 for 414 at the end of day two. Boone is on 29, played some good strokes towards the end, but he really did struggle early on. Bennett is on 8, and the highlight of the day, Kepler-Vessels 173. The West Indies bowling, they were solely concerned with containing in the second part of the day today. Three wickets to Michael Holding, 3 for 74, and Malcolm Marshall, rather strange to see, no wicket against his name there, for 100, and Walsh 1 for 97, with Gomes having his one wicket on the first day. Here's the third over of the day. It's 6 for 420 now, just six runs added, and Walsh is coming in to bowl to Bennett. Your commentators, Keith Stackpole and Tony Gregg.
Well, that's in the air. It's going down towards Richards, who won't get there. Smashing that one away, and it beats him at the other side. Four runs, the crowd loving it. Not a quick single. Garner's in there, and another misfield. That's five out of five. I tell you what they would enjoy now, see four overthrows.
On, off stump, goes right out of the ground. So David Boone is out one short of his 50, comprehensively bowled by the Big Bird. It's a good shot from Murray Bennett, and the outfield slightly quicker here today. It's in the air, Gordon Greenidge under it, and a comfortable catch. It's high in the air. Gordon Greenidge again is the fieldsman. That's his third catch, and they've all been fairly simple. That one he had to move a little bit, and that has brought about the declaration by Alan Border. And he'd be pretty happy with the morning's work. The Australians have taken the score from 414 to 471. They've lost three wickets in doing so, but the runs were importantly scored quite quickly.
Well, that all went according to plan for Alan Border, and a very good session for the Australians, with Boone playing well and then some lusty hitting at the end to enable the closure to be made. Australia 9 for 471 declared. What a pleasure it is to see an Australian side able to do that against the West Indians. Boone out for 49, Bennett for 23, and Lawson and McDermott, they're hitting lustily towards the end. 9 for 471, and the bowling figures for the West Indies: Garner 2 wickets, Holding 3, Walsh 2 and Gomes 1. So around 50 minutes batting for the West Indies before lunch, and then a long haul for them from then on. 471 for 9, a long way to go to save the follow-on. Here's Geoffrey Lawson now bowling the first over of the West Indies innings. No runs on the board. He's bowling to Gordon Greenidge, and your commentator is Frank Tyson.
Runs. Lawson over-pitching. Greenidge very quick to seize upon that. Driving it away through the vacant offside field, vacant because so many men are placed in attacking positions, attacking fielding positions behind them. Well, it wasn't the most convincing of strokes.
Hooks, there's two out. But he finds a gap. That's the way to hook a ball. He rolled the wrist. He put it down. The ball, he's gone. Yes, beautifully bowled. That was quicker. The young man with genuine pace on a dead third day track picked up a vital wicket.
Craig McDermott, the bowler. Richie Richardson takes strike.
Bowled him, yorked him, beautiful piece of bowling, sheer pace, too good, Craig McDermott, bowled him as clean as a whistle, first the attempted bouncer down the leg side, and then the perfect yorker, and out went the off stump, a beauty. Good shot, bad ball, four runs.
Bennett, to bowl to Gomes. Put him down, sharp chance. Got him.
Well bowled. Well bowled.
Rolled that over the top of his fingers. Perfectly pitched for the drive.
Well, he hit that very hard down the ground. In the air. He's out. Got. Drop. What a chance. That was straight in, and how could Greg Ritchie drop that?
Well, they don't come any easier than that. Greg Ritchie holding his face there. Anyone that's played cricket, they know what it's like to drop a catch. That was beautifully bowled by Bob Holland.
He's gone over the top. He's hit that well. Right over the top of mid-on. It was there for him. And Richards having the confidence to lift it over the top. Appeal for a catch. Murray Bennett thought he had him there, looking for his first wicket.
And well caught. Beautifully caught there at short cover. Really was a very good effort. Murray Bennett, spin bowling partner. And they have worked well together as bowlers. That's in the air and well taken. Beautifully taken by Kepler Vessels. That ball spun and Viv Richards followed it. And a tremendous grab there by Kepler Vessels at first slip.
And what a beautiful delivery. The perfect leg break.
Holland to Lloyd.
That one was short. And Lloyd having no trouble hitting that one away to extra cover. That one spins back also a bit short. And once again, almost in exactly the same spot, Lloyd smashing it away. Lawson.
Dujon goes over the top. A little bit of frustration in that shot, but by Jove, he's hit it well. It's gone right through the sideboard. Now that's going to be an interesting, yes, it's a four.
Safe down the ground. It's a massive hit. Miles over.
Well bowled. It's gone in the air and well caught. That's a very good piece of bowling by Bob Holland. Lloyd had got after him. He decided to tie him down. And the perfect delivery. And Lloyd is annoyed.
It's Bob Holland to Marshall.
And an appeal there from Steve Rixon, and he's claimed a victim. Malcolm Marshall just dragging onto the line, and he picks up his fifth wicket in the innings. I guess he's going to have to take up the challenge a bit. In the air, and Bennett has done it. Finally, he has got his first test wicket, and what a well-deserved and hard-earned wicket that is.
And what a very good piece of thinking, because he took that man away from short point, Andrew Hilditch, and he put him behind point.
There's an appeal from Steve Rixon, and Joel Garner is on his way. So that's number six for Bob Holland. Joel Garner out without scoring.
And that's gone down the ground. Someone under it. He's going back. And he takes it. Well taken on the boundary. Well judged catch. Moving back. Always had it in control.
What a terrific performance that was from the Australians. They bowled out the West Indians for 163 with a top score of Haynes 34 and Lloyd made 33. And the hero for Australia, Holland, 6 for 54 from 22 overs and 7 maidens. Bennett, 2 for 45. And this is the first time the West Indies have been asked to follow on in Australia since January 1961. The second innings, we pick up play now in the fourth over. McDermott is the bowler. He's coming in to bowl to Haynes. 7 runs on the board. And Tony Kosier is your commentator.
Appeal. He's gone. Leg before. Desmond Haynes out leg before. And the West Indies have lost their first wicket in the second innings with McDermott striking once more.
A great effort that from the Australians today. The West Indies lost 11 wickets for 194 runs. I'm coming out here to work tomorrow, but I'm also coming out to watch Murray Bennett and Robert Holland in action once again against the best batting side in the world. Here's the first over now. Bob Holland is the bowler. Gordon Greenidge is taking strike and no runs have been added to the overnight total.
Connie's got him. The top spinner has gone straight through Gordon Greenidge as he attempts to cut and knocks the off stump out of the ground. So a marvellous start for Bob Holland in Australia. Off spinner. Oh, and well caught. A brilliant catch there by Graham Wood. Good slower delivery from Geoffrey Lawson.
Listen, Bennett not bowling too many loose deliveries. In the air again, and again they ask the question. This time he's gone.
Well, as we said, it was only a question of time. Keeps lunging the pad at the ball with a bat right alongside it. And Clive Lloyd receives a standing ovation. This will no doubt be the last time that he strides to the middle in a test match in Australia.
And Richards now steps down the wicket to put Bennett down to the boundary. He's gone down the wicket and given that on a mighty slog. That's gone a long way.
Oh, he's got him, the arm ball. Beautifully bowled. And isn't Murray Bennett excited? Well, he might be. That was a beautifully bowled delivery.
And Clive Lloyd out there continuing with those lusty drives of ease. And that too bringing up his 50.
Drives. Gone! Caught by Border at cover.
And the end of a great career for the West Indies captain. 7,515 runs in Test cricket. 72 runs today for him. Be a lot of things flashing through his mind as he walks back to the pavilion for the very last time in Test cricket.
Michael Holding. Got him. He's gone. Yes, first ball. Bit of reflection off. Dixon went to the slip. Vessels, he did the rest, and Holland strikes again.
As the big hit has gone high. And the keeper, Steve Rickson, calls everybody away. And he certainly is a big hitter. Hasn't got hold of this one properly. Bennett is underneath it. And what a good pair of hands Murray Bennett has got. And that's a fitting way for the Test match to end for Australia. Bennett taking a brilliant catch off the bowling of Bob Holland. Holland gets his 10th wicket for the game, 6-4. Murray Bennett played a marvellous part in the Australian victory, which has come by an innings and 55 runs. And Alan Border must be a very, very happy man.
That was a tremendous achievement by Alan Border and his Australian team. Victory by an innings and 55 runs. A marvellous performance from the batsman, first of all, and then from all the bowlers in the side. Not just the spinners, although they did the bulk of the work, but from all the bowlers. The West Indies, in their second innings, all out for 253 to go with the 163 they made in the first innings. A lovely innings from Clive Lloyd today, 72. Vivian Richards, 58. That was one of the most disciplined efforts I've ever seen from him. If ever there was a man going to try and bat through the day, it was Viv Richards today until he was destroyed by Murray Bennett. 253 all out. And the bowling figures for Australia, Lawson 1 for 14, McDermott 2 for 56, Bennett 3 for 79, and Holland 4 for 90.
The crucial second test began with a series of surprises. First, an extraordinary council of war by the Australian selectors, Captain Alan Border and reinstated vice-captain David Hooks. They met beside the controversial Sydney pitch, a reputed spinner's paradise, and decided to make opening bowler Craig McDermott 12th man. That meant that, like New Zealand, Australia would field three spinners, Holland, Matthews and the recalled Ray Bright. New Zealand included Vaughan Brown, Steve Bock, and the specially chosen reinforcement, John Bracewell. The reliable paceman Ewan Chatfield would carry the drinks.
And John Wright off the mark. Found the gap between Hooks and Kerr, and the outfield quite quick here at the SCG.
That's it in the air, and he's gone. It's a breakthrough for Australia. Well, not before time, and a big smile on the face of Alan Border, and indeed Ray Bright.
That is an attempted sweep shot. He may have got a bottom edge on, or it may have just flicked the pad. We'll have to keep an eye on the umpire.
Gone. Second one gone. One to Holland, and one to Bright just a little while ago. Nicely timed by Martin Crowe. It's racing away down to the boundary at the Randwick end.
He's 50. So Edgar, a very positive knock by the New Zealand left-hander.
He's gone, yes, well caught by Border at silly point. Went out very quickly, and Border took a very sharp catch, and Bob Holland strikes again. Beautifully struck and well fielded. Matthews, a chance, he's out, yes! Beautiful piece of 40 by Greg Matthews. What a silly run at this stage of a test match, but Matthews has been brilliant in the field today. He didn't let his side down, there was a chance, he hit the stumps, he had a full-on throw.
That one played away very strongly towards mid-wicket. Well, that's an example of one of those full tosses being hit away for a change.
Slower delivery, and it's gone onto the stumps. You can see from the delight of the keeper, Wayne Phillips, that was the slower delivery. The left-hander, that's got to be very close. Yes, he's on the way, and Bob Holland is on a hat-trick.
Well, that is an interesting one.
And he goes over the top. And he's decided that attack is the best form of defence.
David Hooks. He's gone. Are they available runs?
Well, there's a big peel there. Another one. That's another LBW decision given by Johnson. Holland the bowler again. It wasn't unlike the Brown decision. So Bobby Holland really having a field day out there. Well bowled, it's in the air, is it out? It's out, yes it is. Jeremy Coney doesn't look very happy, but there sound like two noises there.
And that's a great shot, straight down the ground for four. So Stephen Bock now joining in these rather embarrassing moments for Australia.
The batting card for New Zealand. They started off with Wright and Edgar putting together that splendid partnership of 79. Then they had the slump where suddenly they were 8 for 166 and 9 for 169. And Bracewell and Bock for the last wicket have taken the score along to 9 for 270. And 5 penalty runs added for that ball hitting the helmet.
Clipped in the air but wide of David Boone at bat pad. And that brings up the 50 stand for Bock and Bracewell. Tremendous performance from the two tail enders.
Yeah, come on. That's a fine shot.
and it brings up John Bracewell's 50, and that is a very good innings.
Short ball hit in the air down towards square leg. Not a good delivery at all. It won't even be cut off either. Another boundary.
That's got to be close, yes. Umpire Bruce Martin ends the partnership at 124. Bock is out for 37. LBW and Dave Gilbert picks up his first wicket for the innings.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that one. That is Plum. He's out. A big shout. It's been a long day and a couple of hours toil for the Australians. Finally, it's all over. But I think the repercussions of this innings will be felt pretty much by the batting side.
Hadley will be right at the stumps. Phillips off the mark with a very confident flick off the pads and a boundary to start with. Oh, and that's got to be very close. Yes, Robbie Kerr on the way. LBW to Hadley. So Bruce Martin is going to be in for some work at that end today.
Wayne Phillips took 11 from the first over, and he's also made a bit of a mark there on the man at short leg. Always very painful. Sometimes they even wear shin guards close in. It looked to me as though Wayne Phillips struck that with just about perfect timing.
Close, got to be very close. Yes, Plum back and across. They will not go forward, and the great fast bowler strikes again. What a beautiful piece of bowling.
Oh, and a beautiful delivery. What a magnificent delivery. He was brought over here because he could turn the ball a lot, and Jove, didn't that one turn.
That's 3 for 71. Here's Bracewell. And he's produced another one. Don't know if it was as good as the one that knocked over Border, but it certainly accounted for Phillips.
Well, the last 27 balls haven't yielded a run. Come on, Bruce. Oh, and there's a mix-up. And Hooks is out. He's run out for naught. Well, that was a ridiculous run right from the word go. There was a stutter there. Hooks had to respond to Richie's call. Oh, he's hit that one straight down the ground. Beautiful shot. That may be six. What a hit. Magnificent shot by Richie.
Yes, it's been a great day's cricket here again. Australia struggling for a time and then battling through at the end by virtue of that great partnership between Greg Richie, who made 60, and Greg Matthews, 48. They're unbeaten at the close of play, 5 for 175. My word, what a good partnership it was, because they started off at 5 for 71 after Phillips had gone for 31, Kerr for 7, Boone and Hooks for Ducks. Hooks very unlucky to be run out. And Alan Border, who was in great form for his 20, was beaten and bowled by that magnificent delivery from John Bracewell. 5 for 175. And the wicket takers for New Zealand, Richard Hadley, 14 overs, 1 maiden, 2 for 46. It's not a pace bowler's pitch, but still, that great bowler broke through twice, getting Kerr and Boone. And then John Bracewell, the man they're going to fly back to New Zealand next week, 25 overs, 9 maidens, and 2 for 51, just confirming that this is a pitch very much for the spin bowlers.
In the air and just short of Bock. In fact, he may have got a hand to it. Hadley is most upset about it. Warren Brown hasn't made a very good start. A couple of full tosses in this over. Trevor Franklin is going to cut it off just inside the boundary. And that brings up 50 for Greg Matthews. Out there from Hadley off the slower ball, and he's got him. Mel Johnson giving him caught behind down the leg side. There was a faint noise.
He likes that shot.
Anything slightly short, Simon O'Donnell doesn't mind getting away and slashing it away outside off stump. Good shot. And that shot brings up the 200 for Australia.
And he's gone. That long vigil is over, and Hadley has struck again. 4 wickets to Richard Hadley on a spinner's pitch.
Oh, very close.
Yes. And that is the lesson. That ball wasn't turning at all. It was going straight on with the arm.
It's edged and straight to Ian Smith. 5 for Richard Hadley. That's 3 innings in a row in Australia that he's got 5 in an innings. So So 20 wickets already in this series for Richard Hadlee. And he's gone, jumping down the track, trying to hit Stephen Bock over the infield. And Bob Holland is out, and Australia trailed by 66 on the first innings.
It's off the mark. That breaks the drought of runs for New Zealand. A short pitch to Wivery.
In a skill bit at the moment, wasting the new ball. He should keep it after he expects it to swing. No wicket for three at the end of the over.
As he gets off the mark with a nice deflection, Simon O'Donnell, the fieldsman, knocks it back. They take three.
It's a good shot. Made sure that he found the gap. He knew that that's all he had to do to get a boundary.
79 in the first innings in Sydney, and now they've moved on to 95 without loss. Chris Edgar, if you got to touch that, that'll bring up the 50. Watch umpire Martin's single racing away. Yes, a bit of a touch. So Bruce Edgar, for the second time this match, reaches 50. A fine performance on a wicket it's been hard to score runs on. Gone, full pitch, the partnership's over.
He's got him, well caught, beautifully taken. What a catch that was. The ball hit back very firmly to Matthews. Oh, he's bowled him. Bowled him around his legs. Yes, that may have just clipped the edge of the rough. It was tossed up in the air.
Well, that certainly was an intriguing day once again, but New Zealand very much in the ascendancy towards the close of play, and it was only those three quick wickets that got Australia a little bit back into the game. They've really got to get out there tomorrow and break through again, but certainly Alan Border will feel much happier now than he was about an hour from the close of play. The scorecard of 3 for 119 after that opening partnership of 100, the level 100 put on by Wright and Edgar, must have given New Zealand great heart.
He's got him right through Jeremy Coney's defences. A little bit of turn, but also kept low. What a great start there for Bob Holland. He's got him right through him. Well bowled. That might have been the arm ball.
Got him. Another caught and bowled. Well, he's really been frustrating him down at that end. He didn't quite know what to do. Eventually decided to go down the wicket and drive.
Well, he's had a go at that one. And he's hit it well too. Down towards the square leg boundary.
And Ray Bright. Well, Smith doesn't seem to want to go. That looked to be quite a straightforward dismissal. It's rather a rueful glance at the umpire, but I think you'll find he probably hit the ground with the bottom of the bat and the ball came off about 6 inches up the blade. Bright's got through again. Well, Vaughan Brown was completely undecided how to go about this. And that's what I was talking about. Although it's gone so far that you could have had three men standing on one another's shoulders out there. And he's gone. LBW, first ball after lunch.
It's in the air. This has got to be out. Boone takes the catch. Well, no partnership this time around. David Boone has made a contribution at mid-wicket. And that's the end of the New Zealand innings. 260 needed now by Australia to win this test match. And it's going to be a pretty tough match. Oh, and inside edge there. And I thought for a second I heard a second noise. That must have been perilously close to the leg stump. He's in the air and he's got him. What a good catch. Magnificently taken. Drive there by Boone. Has he timed it? Well, he has, and that's not very good fielding by the New Zealand captain. Well, perhaps he thought the other guy was going to cut it off, but he ended out having a little stab at the ball with his toe. Good shot that by Boone, and rather allows him to relieve the pressure a little bit.
So it's going to be a completely new tactical approach from the two captains tomorrow. The reason for that is the way the scorecard finished at 1-4-36 at the close of play. Phillips was on 17 and Boone 6. Kerr the man out for 7, as was the case in the first innings. Out to a brilliant catch by John Wright, diving away at mid-wicket to his right-hand side. John Bracewell, the batting hero for New Zealand in the first innings, a man who took wickets as well, this time is the sole wicket-taker on the board. 1-36 from 21 overs. And the bowling figures for New Zealand, 1-17 to Bracewell. Hadley bowled beautifully again, 9 overs, 5 maidens, none for 7. Crowe took the shine off the ball, and Stephen Bock bowled 2 overs and 2 maidens.
And now Boone has got things rolling this morning. Should be back for a second.
Well, that's well played. Overpitched and driven away by David Boone. That'll do his confidence no end of good. That's the first 4 of the day.
John Bracewell at the backward square leg. And that's the 6th half century only in this test match.
A beautiful shot from Boone. The man had just been moved onto the onside, taken away from squarish point close in. And the next one is short outside off stump. A fine effort from David Boone.
In the air, Bracewell coming around, and he's taken it. So finally the breakthrough. But New Zealand, well, they haven't really sought it, but they've needed it. Border does go over the top, and in that same area where he's just pulled the fieldsman in from, you can bet your bottom dollar he'll be staying out there near the deep mid-wicket area.
And a big appeal there, he's got him. Border trying to smash that on the way to mid-wicket, and once again Bracewell getting his very valuable wicket.
Another quick single there for Boone, and that brings up 1,000 test runs for Greg Ritchie. A shout there from Richard Hadley, but once again, umpire Mel Johnson is unmoved. And well taken, Martin Crowe, what a magnificent catch. Ritchie hit that ball right off the middle of the bat. It was to Crowe's right, but only inches from the turf.
That's out. Boone is gone. Out for 81. Now that puts a different complexion on things. Hooks is hit that way, away over extra cover. Even with the slow outfield, it will still go into the boundary.
That's well hit. Just a couple of bounces and into the advertising hoarding. That's nicely hit. New ball coming off the bat better. Well saved, almost. Stephen Bock got a hand to it, but he knocked it back and then booted it into the boundary. Matthews hitting that one particularly well. Really has played extremely well. This has been a great partnership between Matthews and David Hooks. Good shot. Late cut. Hooks will come back for a third. Just 2 runs needed for victory. And that's fairly close. Yes, on his way. Umpire Mel Johnson gives Greg Matthews out. Matthews, I think, was wandering around to dab a patch on the wicket. And that should be it. Simon O'Donnell timing that one pretty well. Straight down the ground. And Australia needing 260 for victory have done it. The series levelled at 1-1. David Hooks, the vice-captain, joins his captain, Alan Border. And it really has been an amazing victory for Australia. Although, as I've said all day, I think they've had a presentation from Jeremy Coney.
That was a terrific performance from the Australians. They needed 260, that's what they made for the loss of 6 wickets. Some excellent batting performances there. 63 to Phillips and 81 to Boone. Thought Boone played well. He wasn't timing the ball properly all the time. But the partnership was a very good one. Border out for 11 and Richie 13. And then a splendid partnership between Hooks and Matthews. An outstanding performance from them. They put on 66 in only 40 minutes. And that partnership occupied just 10 overs. Then O'Donnell came in and hit the winning run. It's nice for him. It's his first Test match in Australia. And 6 for 260, the winning score, with the bowling figures for New Zealand. Hadley, 2 for 58 from 27.1 overs. Bracewell, 3 for 91. Bock, 1 for 49. And Crowe, Brown and Coney went wicketless. Welcome to the highlights of the first day's play of the final Test match at the Sydney Cricket Ground, Australia against England. England have retained the Ashes. They've also won the series here with that victory down in Melbourne, and a thoroughly deserved win for Mike Gatting and his team. Here, though, at the SCG, the Australians have a chance to fight back. Well, there have been some team changes for both of these sides. First of all, Richie Wellham and Peter Taylor come into the side, and out go David Boone, Greg Matthews, who's 12th man, and Craig McDermott. They're the changes from the Melbourne Test, and England have Graham Dilley back in, and Philip de Freitas is out of the side. And we pick up play now in the fifth over. Just 4 runs on the board. Richie is 2 and Marsh 1. Graham Dilley is coming into bowl to Richie, and your commentators are Ian Chappell and Bob Willis.
No one at third man. And the upfield quite quick. So the first boundary of the morning goes to Greg Richie. Quite a shout from behind, and he's been given. Umpire McConnell had a long look. Greg Richie wasn't all that far forward. I think he was across more than forward.
Brilliantly taken. Appeal for a catch down the leg side. The Englishman can't believe it. Not out, says umpire Randall. It's a shot of the morning. Jeff Marsh plays a perfect cover drive. Gone. Yes, he's caught. After 9 runs off the over, Marsh prods forward.
Been waiting for that. The bounce in this pitch has been very even today.
And he's gone.
Yes, half-hearted sweep shot, standing up. Well caught by both of them at short leg, but it was a half shot. It wasn't really played with any power. Just tried to tuck it around the corner. Very disappointed, Alan Border.
Down the leg side. Inside edge. They weren't sure behind the wicket there. Jack Richards gave it a half appeal. Gladstone Small wasn't completely certain, but Wellham was on his way. About that method of dismissal, all we've got to worry about now is whether Gladstone Small will pick up a hat-trick. Super get away with that for the boundary. Sleep has gone. Small has struck again. What a good series he's having. Embury to bowl to Jones. There it is. He's got it. Embury won't be pleased at that, but Jones will be. The ball is still racing away down there to third man. 3 to Ian Jones. A century for Australia in Australia. Good effort. He's played well right through this series. And in the one-dayers, a very fine performance from Dean Jones. That was a splendid batting performance.
That's out, caught by Gatting at first slip. So Small has struck again, and for the second consecutive test,
He's got 5 wickets in an innings with Zora out for 12.
And Australia went in at the close of play on this first day of the fifth test match at 7 for 236. Well, it was a very interesting finishing score because England did well enough with their bowlers to take those 7 wickets. The Australians fought back after that middle order collapse. A couple of good partnerships, Jones and Broad at 91 and 50 for Marsh and Jones, and then a valuable one between Jones and Zura, 32 in 55 minutes. Not quite enough runs, but at least they're on the board. The bowling figures for England, I thought Gladstone Small bowled superbly today, 5 for 63 from 24 overs and 7 maidens, and that included a spell of 3 for 16 in 17 balls. Dilly 1 for 48 wasn't quite as sharp as we've seen him before. Botham none for 35 was very accurate. Embry none for 26. And Edmonds was the other star bowler for me. Bowled 20 overs, 1 maiden, 1 for 55. The very important third day of the final test of the SCG between Australia and England. Welcome to the highlights. It started with England at the beginning of the day, 5 for 132. They got themselves into trouble yesterday evening. But David Gower, with 62 not out and Jack Richards 8, were set fair to recover things for them this morning. Some excellent bowling from the Australians. Overall, I thought it was a terrific performance from Hughes, Reid and Taylor. Peter Sleep didn't bowl quite so well, but he'll find the ball turning for him today. Hughes 2 for 30, Reid 1 for 38 and Taylor 2 for 28 in a dream debut. We pick it up now in the third over. Just 3 runs have been added to the overnight total. Bruce Reid is the bowler. He's coming in to bowl to David Gower, and your commentators are Mrs. Chappell and Willis.
That's why Richie is a third man, and even he can't cut that one off. Beautiful loop on that occasion, and he's been rewarded with David Gower's wicket. Once again, it was that flight that's gained him the wicket, exactly as it did in Ian Botham's case.
It's well played by Richards. He's a thorough common sense player.
The sweep continues with the slip.
Oh, big appeal there for Caught Behind. All the players in the air, and the umpire is having nothing to do with it. Well, Sleep cannot believe it. Well, I must say, that was a very spontaneous appeal. It looked to me as if there may well have been a nick.
He's gone. Hit straight to cover. So Bruce Reid finally, and at long last, gets his reward. And the partnership for the 7th wicket is broken.
Oh, great catch! Marsh, superb at short leg for the second time in this match, takes a beauty off the centre of the bat from Edmonds. Marsh, as solid as a rock.
You're going to see the off-spinner. Oh, he's bowled him. Clean bowl. Well, it is appropriate that Peter Saylor should do it. It's a turning pitch, and that's given him his 5th wicket in his first test match. What a sterling effort this is. And the crowd here rising to their feet and applauding what has been a magnificent effort. Oh, and that's bowled him. Clean bowled. And what a debut for Peter Taylor. 6 wickets for 78 in his first test match. And he would have to be cheered off the ground by both his colleagues and this good crowd at the Sydney Cricket Ground. England all out for 275, just 68 runs behind the Australian total. So Australia lead by 68 on the first innings, and even Elton John has moved to get onto his feet and cheer off a new name in cricket.
A great cricket fan, Elton John, and nice to see him enjoying himself there after that throat operation. The cards of the innings show that England made 275. Hughes 2 wickets, Reid 2. They both bowled very well in this match. War only 6 overs used in this innings. And Taylor 6 for 78 from 26 overs. We pick it up now in the third over. It's none for 3. Dilly is coming into bowl to Marsh. And your commentators are Ian Chappell. And with him is Doug Walters.
Inside edge and well taken by Jack Richards.
That's a brilliant catch. Magnificently taken, low down at first slip. Adductor muscle or not for John Embry. That's good, a brilliant catch.
He's pulled that one. It's gone down to deep mid wicket for four. Oh, two really good shots from Alan Border.
They certainly were two great shots, and Border played some more as well, and he added 25 to take him through to the close of play, where he remained 38 not out. That was just the type of innings Australia needed, a good attacking captain's innings there. Australia 2 for 74 at the close of this third day. Jones knew exactly what he was doing out there, 6 not out. The bowling figures for England: Dilley 1 for 31, Small none for 10, Edmonds 1 for 12, and Embury no wicket for 18. We pick it up now in the third over. Just 9 runs have been added. Dilley is coming into bowl to Jones. Your commentators are Ian Chappell and Max Walker.
Beautiful straight drive. Border starting to run hard now, and he'll get 4.
Bowled him. So that's the 5th time in the series that Phil Edmonds has got Alan Border.
Oh, and he's got him. He's out caught behind. Oh, and the big appeal there. And he's got him. He's gone too. Wellham doesn't look too happy to me. Well, it really was a question of time. Lamb making the catch there. Oh, well played. And that's going to go down to the boundary. What a nice sweep shot. Well, I'd say that was the best sweep shot we've seen today.
John Embry.
That's out. Played onto the foot, up in the air, and Alan Lamb caught it at short point. Oh, very plumb. No need even to think twice about that. That is as plumb as anything you will see. Good spinning off break with the batsman playing back and not outside the line of off stump.
It's a nice shot. Third boundary for Stephen Waugh. That takes the lead to 249.
Embry to Waugh. That's in the air. And it's caught. Bill Athey takes the catch. Steve Waugh trying to hit Embry over the top. The off spinner had dropped the fielder back deeper. The Union Jacks flutter. The first success. Partnership of 98 valuable runs between Steve Waugh and Peter Taylor.
And he's gone. Eventually, a ball kicks the edge before it goes onto the pad. And that's Peter Taylor's innings ended. And that's John Embry's 7th wicket of the innings. Australia all out for 251.
The card at the end of the innings for Australia was a very fine performance. It showed there Stephen Waugh and Peter Taylor, a partnership of 98 in 134 minutes, and Waugh 73 from 172 balls. That was an innings of real quality. 251 Australia, and the bowling figures for England, an excellent effort from Embury. 46 overs, 15 maidens, 7 for 78, 2 wickets to Edmonds. It was the spinners who did the bulk of the work.
And that's 4. Bruce Reid, no chance at all.
Got him! Caught and bowled! That's the way through that little leg. Chris Border driving, Peter Sweet didn't get to the pitch, chipped it straight back to the leg spinner, and he gets his first wicket, and what a vital wicket for Australia. Nicely played. It's 4. Bilathy playing his first aggressive shot of the innings.
Card at the close of play, England 1 for 39, with Athey 11, Gower 7, Hughes none for 12, Reid none for 4, Sleep 1 for 17. Good piece of work that, to dismiss the opener Chris Broad, who's almost made 500 runs in the series here in Australia, and Taylor no wicket for 3. We pick it up now on the very first over. Peter Taylor, the off-spinner, is coming in. There's no addition to the overnight score. David Gower is taking strike. Here's Ian Chappell, and with him is Doug Walters.
And Gower starts with the boundary. England, 1 for 43. No ball. And that brings a lot of excitement from the crowd.
Catch!
How is that? And he's gone. So Alan Border gets the vital wicket of David Gower. Since the drink scart was on the field, he hasn't scored and he faces Peter Sleep. He's bowled him around his legs. Australia have taken two vital wickets. England are 3 for 91. Dropped it. Mistake again by Zora. Outside edge.
Shouts there of catch it, and that's exactly what's happened. Peter Taylor has picked up the wicket of Alan Lamb. And the quicker one, and he could be out. Dirk Willem has taken the catch, so Ian Botham is out first ball. Peter Taylor has picked him up twice in this test match.
So Peter Taylor on a hat-trick. Botham, much to the delight of the crowd here today, is out first ball for a duck.
The last time there was a hat trick in an Australia versus England test at the SCG, 1891-92. And it still continues to fine bowling from Peter Taylor. This time he goes way over mid on. And in fact, clears the mid on boundary comfortably. England 5 for 123.
Got him? No, dropped him. Wow, that was a straightforward catch. There was no doubt about that one. Flew straight to Border. Border got it, knocked it up, and couldn't get it on the way down. All action at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Australia just letting their chances slip away.
He's gone. Caught and bowled for 96. Steve Waugh takes the return catch. We have a match.
Got in. That's the one. The wrong one through the gap between bat and pad. As Max Walker said, that's the one they were after. 10 overs remaining. The wrong one gets through. A fine innings from Jack Richards. But a wonderful piece of deception by Peter Sleep. Close. Got to be close. That one. Yes, he's got it. Didn't offer a shot, and now two wickets for victory and a hat-trick for Peter Sleep. You beauty, they cry. 9.2 overs to be bowled. The crowd chanting. In comes Sleep. It's short. Catch it, he cries. It's in the top of the pad. He fends them away. Can't be caught out once the ball is dead. When it's in the top of the pad, Gladstone Moore, I don't think, was too sure about that. Gone! He's caught in! Great catch! Umpires confer, yes, he's out. Alan Border taking a catch. And the game, a cliffhanger, a superb catch. It went to ground. The umpire looked a square leg for verification. Peter Sleep, his final delivery. Got it! He's bowled in! 50 for Australia! They've won with one over remaining, so the runabout ends the end of a very memorable test match. Victory by 55 runs, 5 wickets to Peter Sleep, one of the all-time great test matches. Well, what can we say, but that's one of the most exciting finishes you'll ever see. That's it from the SCG. England win the series 2-1. Player of the series is Chris Broad with 3 centuries.